have not heard of it.
It's quite impressive what you've accomplished.
Is that a compliment?
Don't misconstrue. I'm sure the whole endeavor will end tragically. But to have come this far, well, it's more than I ever expected.
The people yearn for freedom but feared to grab hold of it. That fear is gone now.
Thanks to you?
No. This they did on their own.
You diminish your role. But you have always been of humble heart.
I do what is right. No more, no less.
You cannot tell him.
I have to. Otherwise, he will never be safe.
He is safer not knowing. By planting the seeds of doubt, you threaten to topple his entire endeavor. If Washington is paralyzed, Charles Lee will strike. You'll cause the very thing you aim to prevent. Hunt the Templars, as is your duty. But do not drag these men into it.
And for the support of this declaration, with a firm reliance on the protection of divine...
We must now all hang together.
Yes. We must indeed all hang together. Or most assuredly, we shall all hang separately.
You are once more our savior.
I must speak with the commander.
He's gone to try and hold New York. The British intend to take it. I fear we'll need to recall our men from Quebec as well. It's one thing to declare our independence. Now, my friend, we must make it so.
Everything all right?
Sean has located a second power source. I've asked Rebecca to charter a flight for us.
Where to?
Brazil.
Rebecca?
Bad reception. Can you hear me?
Well, glad to see that's working. Guess I'll try you back when I'm topside.
Segurança!
Copy now?
Loud and clear.
What's the plan?
According to our intel, the power source is being worn as a bracelet by some tycoon's trophy wife. We're working on pinpointing her location, but she's most likely inside a VIP booth on the stadium's upper level. I'll update you when I know more.
Now to find a ticket.
We don't have time to play nice. Steal someone else's.
Bit of a dick move, don't you think?
Well, I guess you could try and sneak past security instead.
Doesn't look like normal security.
Because it isn't. Those are Abstergo agents. Cross is probably here too. You need to be careful.
Great. They've set up a checkpoint.
Quick, Desmond! Hide! Blend or do something! Stick close to the crowd and you should be okay. Or look for a way around.
Seriously, what is the deal with stadiums and piss troughs? It's disgusting. And who thought they were a good idea?
Troughs are time and cost efficient.
I don't even see a stall in here. What if I have to take a dump?
Yeah, please just mute the microphone, if you do.
Watch your back, they're on you.
Looks like I'm close. Shit! Another checkpoint.
You're gonna have to find another way around. Security's too tight here.
Como assim? Trabalho aqui há 15 anos e nunca vi nada como isso. Quem vocês pensam que são?
Sugiro abaixar o tom de voz.
Ah, está bem. Faça a porcaria da verificação.
Estou com fome.
Passam 20 minutos simulando sexo anal e fatura milhões. Eu quebro as
costas. Olha, aconteceu, só isso. A gente não queria que acontecesse. Só aconteceu. Sinto muito.
Sente muito? Ela é minha irmã, cara! A porra da minha irmãzinha!
A gente se ama. Pronto, tá aí, tá dito. A gente...
Almost there, Desmond. She's just on the other side of the stadium.
Other side?
We can get back to Connor whenever you're ready, Desmond. Unless you want to plug in the power source first. Up to you.
Did you look for me, Dad? When I was gone?
Every day.
Come on.
I mean it. Every night I'd look, searching for your name or variations of it, hoping you'd slip up. Abstergo only found you first because they had better access. A few more days and it would have been me.
Well, I'm here now.
And I'm glad.
Do you think Lucy regretted what she was doing?
I used to think I knew her well, but clearly that wasn't the case. So I really can't give you an honest answer.
She seemed so sincere, though. Like she really wanted to make a difference.
Yes, well, when I first met him, I thought the same thing about Cross.
It just keeps happening over and over again.
What does?
Everything.
Don't get weird on me, Desmond.
No, it's fine. I'm fine. Don't worry.
All right, then. You should think about getting back in the Animus. We've got to find that key.
Oh, unbelievable.
What's up?
Your politicians are constantly referencing the Founding Fathers, insisting they must have been in support of one thing or another. I have never seen such a blatant disregard for history.
That's just typical political propaganda.
It's also dishonest and delusional. How can anyone claim to know what these people wanted based off scraps of paper and wishful thinking?
They're looking for intent. What these men envision for our country and its future.
Idealistic and unlikely. I don't think most of your presidents and senators and judges care what the founders thought. They just want to know how they can bend old words to achieve modern goals. Who cares if they were deists or theists or wanted a central bank? Why do people need the validation? What should matter is what you, as an individual, believe and why you believe it. What, are we so insecure that we have to find 18th century letters to validate our beliefs? Oh, look, Mum, a dead man agreed with me. Maybe. If you transpose the letters in his shopping list, you can plainly see he was on my side.
Jesus, Sean. That's a cynical way to look at it.
Doesn't make it less true. I keep trying to understand how men like Washington and Jefferson could dedicate their lives to the pursuit of liberty and equality, yet have no problem owning slaves. It's hypocritical in the extreme, and your history books make only passing mention of the subject, as if it were of little consequence.
They had a war to win. Country's future to secure. How could they deal with all these issues at the same time?
Spoken like a true apologist. We hear it today, too, that matters of civil rights and equality must wait. There are conflicts to settle, economies to salvage. What do any of these things matter if the people are not free and equal? All of them.
So, what's the latest? Learn anything interesting while you were exploring?
They were working on some weird stuff towards the end. Trying to engineer new bodies and store their minds inside computers.
Failure after failure. It must have been hard for them.
I worry about it too. I mean, they say there's something in here that'll help us. But what is it? Why is it locked up if it's exactly what we need?
I don't know. Maybe it's dangerous. Maybe they wanted to make sure only you could reach it.
That's the other question. What makes me so special?
I guess we'll know once we open the door. Hey, I hope it's not uncomfortable for me to ask, but what happened with Lucy?
I don't know.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said anything.
No, it's fine. I really don't know. I was talking to my dad about it. It's hard to say. I mean, Juno definitely took control, but I think I agreed to it on some level. I think I let her in. No. That's not right. It wasn't her. Not exactly. It was more like a program. Does that sound weird? It showed me things.
What'd you see?
That if I didn't stop Lucy, Abstergo would get the apple, and we'd all be dead.
I still don't understand why she turned on us.
I'm sure she thought she was doing the right thing.
Wonder what's inside.
Only one way to find out.
In its existence, and only awaiting discovery? Or might it be changed? Here we learned the answer, and thought that it might save us. They were used to command, to control, to own. But we soon discovered another use. When enough sat enthralled and were told to believe, their thoughts took on form. What was imagined became real. If 100 minds could wish away a wall or create a tree, what might 1,000 do? 10,000? More? Might we change the consensus and will the threat away? We resolved to send one into the sky where it might illuminate us all. Once placed, a sentence would be uttered. Make us safe. In this way, we would change the consensus. We would save the world. But it never came to be. We sent 12 of them skyward, but there was no way to maintain control. To direct the beam, to enthrall the world, to speak the words. Though this was strange and dangerous, what we tried next was worse. Travel back to change the past, but we could not find a way. But forward, we could look forward, and so here we sought to see beyond ourselves and know what was to come. First, we watched to learn if our work would succeed, but the answer was always the same, so we moved on to other things. But she remained. the one you call Minerva. In time, she too stopped looking, and instead began to speak. She called out across time, in the hopes that you might be saved. She hid messages where none might find them, save for you and those within this place.
Fascinating.
Tired of it. The cryptic warnings, the threats. Just tell us what you want!
But they are. We saw the Nephilim there. We seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Imagine trying to explain all this to a 2-year-old, to a grasshopper. When they said the will of the gods was unknowable, they meant it. Literally.
I killed her, you know. I killed Lucy.
It was the apple, son. It was Juno.
I saw what she was. What would happen if I let her live? I could have stopped myself. I mean, there was a force there. But I didn't have to. I chose to.
Desmond.
Lucy was going to betray us and take the apple back to Abstergo. I saw the satellite launched. I saw them turn it on, and then it failed. Whatever's on the other side of that door, it benefits Juno. We need to be careful.
There's something down here.
Don't be daft.
I don't know. Maybe they were sleeping or something and we woke them. Some kind of cryogenics? Or hibernation? I mean, how do we know what the hell they were doing down here?
They were working on a bunch of different solutions, but nothing worked. Just went from one to the next, and then I don't know. They must have left at some point. After the end.
I wonder what the world would be like if they'd succeeded.
I'm more concerned about what it'll be like if we don't.
Salvation. They found a way. Too late for them, but not for you. Sealed to protect it. Though now it bars your way. Find the key. The past will tell.
Do you think Lucy regretted what she was doing?
I used to think I knew her well, but clearly that wasn't the case. So I really can't give you an honest answer.
She seemed so sincere, though. Like she really wanted to make a difference.
Yes, well, when I first met him, I thought the same thing about Cross.
It just keeps happening over and over again.
What does?
Everything.
Don't get weird on me, Desmond.
No, it's fine. I'm fine. Don't worry.
All right, then. You should think about getting back in the Animus. We've got to find that key.
Oh, unbelievable.
What's up?
Your politicians are constantly referencing the Founding Fathers, insisting they must have been in support of one thing or another. I have never seen such a blatant disregard for history.
That's just typical political propaganda.
It's also dishonest and delusional. How can anyone claim to know what these people wanted based off scraps of paper and wishful thinking?
They're looking for intent. What these men envision for our country and its future.
Idealistic and unlikely. I don't think most of your presidents and senators and judges care what the founders thought. They just want to know how they can bend old words to achieve modern goals. Who cares if they were deists or theists or wanted a central bank? Why do people need the validation? What should matter is what you, as an individual, believe and why you believe it. What, are we so insecure that we have to find 18th century letters to validate our beliefs? Oh, look, Mum, a dead man agreed with me. Maybe. If you transpose the letters in his shopping list, you can plainly see he was on my side.
Jesus, Sean. That's a cynical way to look at it.
Doesn't make it less true. I keep trying to understand how men like Washington and Jefferson could dedicate their lives to the pursuit of liberty and equality, yet have no problem owning slaves. It's hypocritical in the extreme, and your history books make only passing mention of the subject, as if it were of little consequence.
They had a war to win. Country's future to secure. How could they deal with all these issues at the same time?
Spoken like a true apologist. We hear it today, too, that matters of civil rights and equality must wait. There are conflicts to settle, economies to salvage. What do any of these things matter if the people are not free and equal? All of them.
So, what's the latest? Learn anything interesting while you were exploring?
They were working on some weird stuff towards the end. Trying to engineer new bodies and store their minds inside computers.
Failure after failure. It must have been hard for them.
I worry about it too. I mean, they say there's something in here that'll help us. But what is it? Why is it locked up if it's exactly what we need?
I don't know. Maybe it's dangerous. Maybe they wanted to make sure only you could reach it.
That's the other question. What makes me so special?
I guess we'll know once we open the door. Hey, I hope it's not uncomfortable for me to ask, but what happened with Lucy?
I don't know.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said anything.
No, it's fine. I really don't know. I was talking to my dad about it. It's hard to say. I mean, Juno definitely took control, but I think I agreed to it on some level. I think I let her in. No. That's not right. It wasn't her. Not exactly. It was more like a program. Does that sound weird? It showed me things.
What'd you see?
That if I didn't stop Lucy, Abstergo would get the apple, and we'd all be dead.
I still don't understand why she turned on us.
I'm sure she thought she was doing the right thing.
Wonder what's inside.
Only one way to find out.
In its existence, and only awaiting discovery? Or might it be changed? Here we learned the answer, and thought that it might save us. They were used to command, to control, to own. But we soon discovered another use. When enough sat enthralled and were told to believe, their thoughts took on form. What was imagined became real. If 100 minds could wish away a wall or create a tree, what might 1,000 do? 10,000? More? Might we change the consensus and will the threat away? We resolved to send one into the sky where it might illuminate us all. Once placed, a sentence would be uttered. Make us safe. In this way, we would change the consensus. We would save the world. But it never came to be. We sent 12 of them skyward, but there was no way to maintain control. To direct the beam, to enthrall the world, to speak the words. Though this was strange and dangerous, what we tried next was worse. Travel back to change the past, but we could not find a way. But forward, we could look forward, and so here we sought.
It's quite impressive what you've accomplished.
Is that a compliment?
Well, don't misconstrue. I'm sure the whole endeavor will end tragically. But to have come this far, well, it's more than I ever expected.
The people yearn for freedom but feared to grab hold of it. That fear is gone now.
Thanks to you?
No. This they did on their own.
You diminish your role. But you have always been of humble heart.
I do what is right. No more, no less.
You cannot tell him.
I have to. Otherwise, he will never be safe.
He is safer not knowing. By planting the seeds of doubt, you threaten to topple his entire endeavor. If Washington is paralyzed, Charles Lee will strike. You'll cause the very thing you aim to prevent. Hunt the Templars, as is your duty. But do not drag these men into it.
And for the support of this declaration, with a firm reliance on the protection of divine...
We must now all hang together. Yes. We must indeed all hang together. Or most assuredly, we shall all hang separately.
You are once more our savior.
I must speak with the commander.
He's gone to try and hold New York. The British intend to take it. I fear we'll need to recall our men from Quebec as well. It's one thing to declare our independence. Now, my friend, we must make it so.
Everything all right?
Sean has located a second power source. I've asked Rebecca to charter a flight for us.
Where to?
Brazil.
Rebecca?
Bad reception. Can you hear me?
Well, glad to see that's working. Guess I'll try you back when I'm topside.
Loud and clear. Almost there, Desmond. She's just on the other side of the stadium.
Other side?
We can get back to Connor whenever you're ready, Desmond. Unless you want to plug in the power source first. Up to you.
Did you look for me, Dad? When I was gone?
Every day.
Come on.
I mean it. Every night I'd look. searching for your name or variations of it, hoping you'd slip up. Abstergo only found you first because they had better access. A few more days.
What's the plan?
According to our intel, the power source is being worn as a bracelet by some tycoon's trophy wife. We're working on pinpointing her location, but she's most likely inside a VIP booth on the stadium's upper level. I'll update you when I know more.
Now to find a ticket.
We don't have time to play nice. Steal someone else's.
Bit of a dick move, don't you think?
Well, I guess you could try and sneak past security instead.
Doesn't look like normal security.
Because it isn't. Those are Abstergo agents. Cross is probably here too. You need to be careful.
Great. They've set up a checkpoint.
Quick, Desmond! Hide! Blend or do something! Stick close to the crowd and you should be okay. Or look for a way around it.
Seriously, what is the deal with stadiums and piss troughs? It's disgusting. And who thought they were a good idea?
Troughs are time and cost efficient.
I don't even see a stall in here. What if I have to take a dump?
Yeah, please just mute the microphone, if you do.
Watch your back, they're on you.
Like I'm close. Shit! Another checkpoint.
You're gonna have to find another way around. Security's too tight here.
Como assim? Trabalho aqui há 15 anos e nunca vi nada como isso. Quem vocês pensam que são?
Sugiro abaixar o tom de voz.
Ah, está bem. Faça a porcaria da verificação.
Olha, aconteceu, só isso. A gente não queria que acontecesse. Só aconteceu. Sinto muito.
Sente muito? Ela é minha irmã, cara! A porra da minha irmãzinha!
A gente se ama. Pronto, tá aí, tá dito. A gente se...